Hello, just been sitting in a patch of sun on my couch, like the cat that I am. I've had a really shitty week, to be honest. Nothing's happened. It's just one of those emotional, tiring, blah kind of weeks. I've just felt so lacking in energy, really unmotivated. Just really tired. And I got my period a couple of days ago, which explains a lot, and I've been getting it for years and years and years. Continues to baffle me every single month when it does arrive, and I wonder why I've been feeling so low. A couple of days ago, I just had one of those days where I just kept weeping. Like, it was almost funny, when you're just kind of in it and you're like, this is just, I'm so hormonal, but I can't stop it. It's just happening to me. Just been eating a lot of snacks, a lot of sugar. Haven't been for a run this week, and that's absolutely fine as well. So I thought I'd just kind of like hang out with you for the next couple of days and just kind of show you what I do when I'm feeling a bit yuck, like, which isn't a lot. It's just being very gentle with myself, taking it easy and just kind of going with the flow. Eating comforting food, reading, keeping cozy, doing very gentle exercise. It's a really beautiful day today. It's one of those lovely, crisp winter days, and the sun's been coming in and out. So I'm gonna go for a nice long walk, I think. Listen to a podcast and just, I don't know, have some fresh air. I think it'll be really nice for me. And you can come too. That walk was just what the doctor ordered. It's funny, I've been kind of procrastinating going for a walk today. I was like, oh, should I do it or should I just read my book and chill? And I just kind of made myself do it. And then as soon as I was out the door and started walking, I was like, oh, this is the right thing to be doing. I love autumn. I think it's one of my favorite seasons. I love the kind of in-between seasons, so like autumn and spring. Just find this time of the year, like the air smells different. It's just like so fresh and lovely. It was just good to kind of like move my body in an easy kind of way and listen to a podcast and just completely escape for an hour. Just didn't really think about anything. It was really good. Just ate an orange and now I'm gonna have a nice hot shower. I love having hot showers when I'm feeling a bit bleh. I just find them so like soothing and comforting and just like, I don't know, I just stand there and I feel like I could probably stand there for like an hour in the water. Something about water, hey, it's just so healing. Anyway, I'm gonna do that and then put in some comfy clothes and just chill out for the rest of the evening.
Thank you.
y'all know what time it is. Time to talk about books. It's been a hot minute and I've been busy. I've got three books to talk about. The first one is Gone Girl. I kind of picked this up on a whim. Dan brought it from an op shop for like $5. It's one that I've been kind of meaning to read for a while. I remember when it first came out and it was like really hyped, and then they made a movie out of it. And I kind of just forgot about it. So I picked it up, I read a couple of pages, and I was like, all right, I'm hooked. I'm hooked already. It's a thriller mystery about a husband and wife, and the wife goes missing. I won't really tell you anything else about that, but it was a really good book. Nice little twist in there. I hated both the main characters. I found them really irritating and annoying. But I think you were kind of meant to. If you read it before, let me know what you think. But yeah, I thought it was a really good book. Really engaging. You just kind of, one of those thrillers where you just kind of have to know what happens, which is, I think, a really good sign of a good thriller where you can't put it down. Yeah, would really recommend it. And after I read it, I also watched the movie, which I also thought was really, really good. After that, I read The Convenience Store Woman, which is such a lovely book, by a Japanese author, and it's just so uniquely Japanese. It even says on the back of here, quirky, memorable, it could only be Japanese. It's about a woman who works in a convenience store, obviously, and kind of her day-to-day life. Yeah, a lovely, lovely book, really gorgeous. Highly recommend it. It's super easy to get through. Good in-between book. Yeah, just lovely. Really, really good. And just finished Shaggy Bane. Now, this is probably one of the best books I've read in a really, really long time. It is a heavy read. It's not an easy one to get through as far as like the subject matter. Definitely not a holiday read or anything like that, but incredible. So it's set in the 1980s in Glasgow, and it's about a family, particularly focusing on the mother and her youngest son, Shaggy. The mother is an alcoholic, and I thought it was a really accurate description of active addiction and the devastation and destruction that comes with it. Really heartbreaking, really heart-wrenching. I cried when I read it, and I had a couple of sleepless nights because I read before I go to sleep. And yeah, it kind of kept me up because you keep thinking about it. But yeah, really, really beautiful book. Highly, highly recommend it. I want everyone to read this book. It was phenomenal. So yeah, those are the last three books I read. It's been a good reading session at the moment, which is awesome. I'm going to read The Dutch House next, which I'm excited about. Picked this up a few weeks ago. I can't even remember what it's about, but I remember it was highly recommended to me. It's a beautiful color as well. But yeah, if you have any book recommendations for me, please put them down below. I always write a list. I've got this really long list on my phone. Yeah, I love hearing about what other people are reading. It is Sunday. The time is 1 o'clock. I've been working this morning. And then I got home and have been editing this video. And I feel like it is all over the place. And I was thinking about what I could add to make it more interesting. Maybe I should film a Pilates workout, but I just do not have the energy for it. And that's just what my week's been like, and I want to make it realistic, so I don't want to force anything. But I'm sorry if it's been a bit all over the place and a little bit boring. I know I say that a lot, but I'm quite hard on myself. I like my videos to look good and for you to take something away when you watch it. I feel like I didn't really do that with this one. But at the same time, like, I really like doing more kind of raw vlogs, and I actually love watching those on YouTube, but I think I just need to let go of a bit of perfectionism there. And like, for me, it's about, you know, making something. It doesn't have to be perfect, doesn't have to look perfect, but it's making something and putting it out there so that I can connect with people and connect with people from all around the world. Like, it's such a joy, you know, to be able to do that and to have YouTube as a space where I can do that. So consistency is really important for me. And there was a part of me that was like, oh, maybe I should just like scrap this video and wait until something interesting happens or I have something to talk about. But I really just want to post a video this week. And my week has been exhausting and I've been feeling really flat and low. And that's just a part of life. And I know that it will pass because it always does. Monday, tomorrow, start of a fresh new week, which I'm excited for. I love Mondays because of that. What I thought I would do though is just kind of like fill you in on what's been going on, a little bit of a quick life update. The house is great. Dan and I are so happy. We're just kind of slowly making it ours, you know, like collecting little knickknacks and got some prints ordered. There's one behind me actually. Just kind of making it feel like our space, and it's looking really beautiful. I feel like Dan and I as a couple just are a lot happier as well, like in our own space, creating a home together. It's just been so special. Yeah, we're just really happy there. Work's been really quiet for the last couple of weeks. That's the nature of the beast, unfortunately, when it comes to like hospitality. Just kind of like putting one foot in front of the other, and it's given me space to kind of change up the menu a little bit though, which has been fun. And yeah, just trying to stay optimistic. I definitely have weeks where I'm like, oh, I wish I had more orders, and I freak out and worry about money, but that's just what it's like having your own business. It's always going to be a little bit stressful, but at the same time I would rather be doing this and working for somebody else, so I'm really happy still. With running, I haven't ran at all this week, which is the first time in a long time where I haven't gone for one run, but I think my body has really, really needed the rest. I do have a couple of running goals coming up, probably. I've just been kind of thinking about it, but I think I was just having a look online before at some dates of events, and I think it'll be really good for me to have something to train for, so I think I'll talk about that in my upcoming video. But I'm excited to get back into running. I feel like I'm not as fit as I was. I usually stay pretty consistently like half marathon fit, but I don't think I'm there at the moment, and I can kind of feel it in my body, but that's all good. It's kind of something to build up towards. It's always quite fun. And other news, I have been looking into getting a puppy. I've been wanting a miniature schnauzer for a really long time. Started looking into it at the end of last year, contacting different breeders and just waiting. It's been a lot of waiting, a lot of email back and forth. A couple have fallen through. One of the dogs that is in Adelaide, the breeder is in Adelaide, her dog had a ghost pregnancy, which was really sad, so that, obviously that didn't happen. And then last week, I think it was, we contacted a breeder in Melbourne and her dog is pregnant, but she doesn't take waiting lists, and she's written our name down though, and we're going to call her on the 1st of June and we'll know then if we have a puppy. But I don't want to get too excited, even though I already am, because I know it can really easily fall through. It's quite competitive getting a dog. I know it's just going to be a waiting game, but oh, I want one so badly. It's so funny, like, so we had Sarge, which is Dan's golden retriever. You would have seen him in our video. So that's Dan's dog, but because he's older, he lives with Dan's mum and dad now, because he's just really familiar with that space, and it would just be kind of mean to bring him here. But I really feel the absence of not having an animal around. When I was growing up, we always had cats, and I was always such a cat person, and I still love cats. And then when my cat Samson died, my parents got a miniature schnauzer, and I realized I was also a dog person. But I love animals. I really need them around. I find them really comforting and really therapeutic. And I have a lot of love and affection to give. So yeah, I'm just like pining for an animal. So sorry. We'll see what happens. All my fingers and toes are crossed. Yeah. Try not to think about it too much. But yeah, that's it. Life's ticking away. We're pretty much in a set little routine at the moment, you know, like work, home, movement, books. That's kind of it. It's a sleepy kind of country life, but yeah, I'm pretty happy to be here. Anyway, I'm going to stop rambling and just say Thanks for being here. I hope you took something out of this video. Thank you for taking time out of your day to watch. And yeah, I hope you're doing really well wherever you are. Let me know what's going on with you. I love to know what's going on in people's lives. I love getting comments. They always make my day. And yeah, sending heaps and heaps of love, and I'll see you in the next one.